Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo. By the causes myself, Sri Guru and Gauranga, now we have come to this supremely pure transcendental holy place, Sri Vasanga. This is the courtyard of Srivas Thakur. Who is Srivas Thakur? He is the incarnation of Narada Muni. He is the incarnation of the pure devotee.
Он инкарнация, он образец чистого преданного.
Narada Muni is eternal associate of Sri Krishna.
Narada Muni это вечный преданный Шри Кришне.
He is serving in all the leelas of Krishna.
Он служит во всех лилах Кришны.
And the leelas of Lord Ramachandra.
И также в лилах Господа Рамачандры.
And the leelas of Lord Narayan.
И в лилах Господа Нараяны.
Narada Muni is the guru of Prahlad Maharaj.
Narada Muni, духовный учитель самого Прохлада Махараджа.
He is the guru of Dhruva Maharaj.
Он гуру Друвы.
He is the guru of Chitraketu Maharaj.
Гуру Читракету Махараджа.
Narada Muni is even the guru of Yogamaya Purnamasi Devi.
Он даже гуру самой Пурнамаси Йогамайи.
Yogamaya Purnamasi is the Leela Shakti organizing all the pastimes of Sri Krishna. And Srivas Thakur, in the form of Narada Muni, is her guru.
Пурнамаси Йогамайя заведует всеми лилами Кришна, нами управляет, а Шривас Такур в облике Нарады Муни является ее гуру.
So how great is Srivas Thakur?
Поэтому трудно представить, насколько велик Шривас Такур.
But in this incarnation, he plays the role of very simple and poor devotee, poverty-stricken devotee.
И вот эта величайшая личность в лилах Господа Гауранги играет роль чуть бедного брахмана.
When Nimai,
можно сказать, нищего.
When Nimai was a student,
когда Нимай еще был учеником,
and he was doing his Vidya-Vilas,
и он совершал Vidya-Vilas,
that means his pastimes of education. At that time, Nimai, he was not practicing devotional service. He was absorbed in Navinyai logic. And in quarreling with other students over Sanskrit grammar. And sometimes Srivas Thakur would meet him. And Srivas would say, "Oh Nimai, you are studying grammar, but the purpose of studying grammar is to study the scriptures, and the purpose of studying the scriptures is to become a devotee. So if you just study and study and study, but you don't become a devotee, then all your studies are useless."
Srivas Thakur пытался образумить подростков, был Нимай, послушай, изучение грамматических правил предназначено для того, чтобы ты смог изучать шастры. А изучение шастр предназначено для того, чтобы познать Господа и служить Ему. Но если ты вечно только учишься, но не служишь Господу, вообще какой толк в твоих этих занятиях?
Don't waste your life, Nimai Pandit.
Не надо тратить жизнь попусту.
Nimai was very respectful.
Но Nimai очень...
Very, this is good advice.
Очень вежливо отвечал всегда Шривас Такуру, но спасибо за хороший совет.
After Mahaprabhu's father passed away.
Позже, после того, как Джаганнат Миша, папа Nimai Пандита...
He went to Gaya to offer pinda. Do the rituals for his deceased father.
Nimai отправился в Гаю, чтобы совершить ритуал подношения шрадху, там, пинду за своего усопшего отца.
And there he met his Gurudev, Srila Ishwara Puripad, and received initiation.
Там он снова встретил Шилу Ишвара Пурипада и попросил стать его учеником.
And Nimai Pandit, by chanting the holy names, he had the darshan of Krishna, and he was completely transformed.
И как только он стал повторять святые имена, он полностью стал другой личностью. Он трансформировался и увидел Кришну.
When he was returning to Navadvip, some Navadvipvasi saw him. I said, "Oh, Nimai, how was your Тирсаятра, visit to the holy place.
И вернулся сюда уже совершенно иным человеком. И когда жители Навадвипы повстречали его, спросили: «О, Нимай, как прошла твоя Тирхаятра в Гаю?»
Нимай Пандит folded his hands and said, «By your mercy, it was successful».
Очень кротко, сложив ладони, он сказал: «По вашей милости, этот визит в Гаю был успешным».
They said, «What happened to Нимай?»
Подумали, что с ним случилось?
He was a proud Pandit, going everywhere, challenging everyone and arguing with them. And now, by your mercy on me, it was successful.
А что с ним произошло? Потому что всегда был очень дерзким, высокомерным, всегда, потому что он был очень умным, он был надменным, гордился своей учёностью, всегда достаточно дерзко разговаривал со всеми.
What did you say there?
Кратки, как огнец Божий, такой, по вашей милости, всё прошло благополучно.
Mabu said, I had darshan. But there's one place called Padudak Tirsa where there are the footprints of Bhagavan. And when he said, I had darshan of the footprints of Hari, he began to tremble and tears came in his eyes.
И как только он стал рассказывать о том, что он посетил это место, где он увидел отпечатки стоп Хари, как только он произнес имя Хари, слезы тут же полились у него из глаз.
And he could not speak. He said, I'll meet you. Meet me tomorrow morning in the house of Shuklambaba Brahmachari.
Голос его задрожал, он сказал: «Давайте завтра утром встретимся в доме Шукламбара Брахмачари».
The next morning, Shrivas Thakur was here in his garden.
И на следующее утро Shrivas Thakur был тут во дворе своего дома.
There was a beautiful jasmine tree.
И тут рос огромный жасминовый куст.
And in the early morning, the few local Vaishnavas who were here in Navadvip at that time, they used to come to Shiva Sangam, this courtyard, and they used to pick flowers from this tree. It didn't matter how many they picked, there was always enough flowers for everyone's puja.
И все вайшнавы, друзья, не многочисленные вайшнавы, которые в эти времена жили в Навадвипе, друзья Шривас Такура, каждое утро приходили к этому жасминовому кусту собрать цветочков для своей пуджи, своим такуруджи. И сколько бы цветов не собирались с этого куста, на нем всегда оставались цветы.
At that time, Sri Mahan Pandits, who had seen Mahaprabhu return, but the other vaishnavas had not seen, he arrived there with a big smile on his face.
И этим утром, когда все вайшнавы стояли во дворе, собирали цветы, Шриман Пандит, который прошлой ночью повстречал Нимай Пандита, с огромной улыбкой на лице, вошел во двор.
The vaishnava said, "Oh, Shriman Pandit, you look exceedingly happy today."
Вайшнавы тут же увидели чрезмерно и спросили: "Ты что-то очень радостным сегодня выглядишь?"
Shriman Pandit said, "Indeed, I am."
Шриман Пандит сказал: «Да, я по факту очень счастлив сегодня».
Pray tell us, what is the cause?
Очень любопытно, может ты поведаешь нам, в чем причина такой чрезмерной радости?
Shriman Pandit said, you won't believe it.
Шриман Пандит сказал: «Да вы не поверите вообще».
And then Shrivas Thakur and other Vaishnavas, they're all standing around, tell us.
Он тут же заинтриговал своим ответом всех вайшнавов, они приблизились.
No, you'll never believe what happened.
Shrivas Thakur вдруг сказал: «Ну давай рассказывай». Да вы не поверите.
Tell us.
Ну расскажи уже.
Nimai Pandit has become a Vaishnava.
И тут он сказал: «Nimai Pandit стал вайшнавом».
When Shrivas Thakur heard this, he was overwhelmed with joy. And then he gave a blessing. May the Vaishnava family expand. And by that blessing of Shrivas Thakur spoken here beneath his jasmine tree, we are all here today.
Коснулось нас всех вот в то утро, когда он произнес это благословение, стоя в своем дворе рядом с жасминовым кустом. Вот поэтому мы с вами тут все.
Just see how the transcendental Vaishnav family is expanding and expanding all over.
Смотрите, как удивительным образом вайшнавская семья трансцендентная растет.
So when Nimai came back to Navadvip, he was no longer Nimai Pandit. The Pandit, the scholar, now he was Rasik Nimai, Bhavuk Nimai.
То есть Nimai Pandit уже не возвращался в Навадвип, всегда вернулся уже Rasik Bhavuk Nimai.
And he was having such ecstatic symptoms, crying, roaring, belching.
Его экстатические состояния были очень мощными. Он рыдал, смеялся, так, странные звуки издавал.
Many people thought that he had gone mad.
Многие поверили, что он сошел с ума.
His mother called the Ayurvedic doctor, I think my son has a derangement of the prana, the life
essence. Мама Шачи вызвала ортопедического доктора, потому что он осмотрел сына, потому что она думала, что у него вышла вата доша из баланса.
So at that time, Nimai Pandit came to Srivas Thakur. He said, oh Srivas, am I ill? Srivas Thakur said, if you are ill, whatever disease you have, I want that disease. He said, this is not illness. This is the symptom of bhakti. Then Nimai Pandit was very relieved. He said, oh Srivas, if you had also said that I was ill, then I would have jumped in the Ganga and given up my life. So Nimai Pandit has so much ashraddha and love for Srivas Thakur. When Nimai met Nityananda Prabhu for the first time in the place where we were, Nandanacharya Bhavan. Then he brought Nityananda Prabhu here. He said, you stay in the house of this Brahmin Srivas. And so Srivas Thakur and his wife Malini, they adopted Nityananda
Prabhu.
But Nityananda Prabhu, he was so absorbed in praying that his behavior was quite bizarre. He's known as Avadut. That means a person who's in such transcendental ecstasy that none of the rules and regulations of etiquette and behavior of this world apply to that person. So sometimes he would just walk around with no clothes, thinking that he was Balaram, being only 5 years old, playing in the dust of Vrindavan. Sometimes he used to wear a dhoti.
On his head.
One day, Nimai Pandit came to Srivas Thakur. He said, Srivas, you have a very good reputation. So why are you letting this crazy person live in your house? No one knows where he is from or who his family, what his gota or anything. Mahaprabhu said, Srivas, I think that you should turn this mad person out from your house. So then Srivas Thakur said, oh my Lord, don't try to test me. I know that Nityananda Prabhu and yourself, you are abhinna tattva, non-different. Nityananda Prabhu is your heart. And if anyone has devotion to Nityananda Prabhu, then automatically you'll love them. So I don't care whatever Nityananda Prabhu can do or say. Yadyapi Nityananda Suri Parijai Tadapi Nityananda Tadapi Seyama Nityananda Rai. Srivas Thakur says, if Nityananda Prabhu, I see him going into a pub
Даже если я увижу, что он
заходит into a liquor house,
куда-то в литероводочный магазинчик,
or even if Nityananda Prabhu marries a Muslim girl,
или даже если он женится на мусульманке,
I don't care. Still, he's my life and soul.
Мне все равно, он моя жизнь, он мое сердце.
When Nimai Pandit heard Shrivas Thakur's deep faith in Nityananda Prabhu,
когда Nimai Pandit услышал эти слова,
he became in ecstasy.
Он так обрадовался.
And he jumped on Shrivas Thakur.
Он так прыгал на Shrivas Thakur.
Shrivas! What did you say? What did you say about my Nityananda? Because you have understood the deep tattva of my Nityananda. Therefore you have purchased me. You will attain Krishna Prem. No. All your family members will attain Krishna Prem. No, not only your family members, all the servants and everyone living in your house will attain Krishna Prem. No. Even your pets, your dogs and cats will attain Krishna Prem. No! Anyone who says your name, Shrivas!
Shrivas! Shrivas! Shrivas! Shrivas! Shrivas! Shrivas! Shrivas!
They will all attain Krishna Prem! Because of your nishta, your sraddha, your faith in the lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda Prabhu ki! One day, the wife of Shrivas Thakur, Malini Devi, she was doing puja, and she had a little silver cup for her takoji. And one crow flew down and grabbed the cup and flew away. And Malini began to cry, oh! The crow has stolen my Thakurji's paraphernalia. Nityananda Prabhu came. Oh, mother, don't cry. And the crow was very far away in flying in the distance. Nityananda Prabhu said, hey, crow, come back! And the crow was flying, he just turned around, came back and put the silver cup back down on the archies, right? Nityananda was just smiling. Malini was saying, who is this
Nityananda?
So this is the place where Mahaprabhu and all of his associates used to come every evening and have Maha Sankirtan, chanting the holy names for the whole night, every night.
At
the PSA Lila Karigor Rai, Kongon Bhagavani Deki Paripai. So that Lila of Mahaprabhu and Panchatattva, all associates doing Maha Sankirtan here, is going on even today. And those who are fortunate, they have eyes to see it. In those days, at that time, this Maha Sankirtan was secret. It took place behind closed doors. No one could go in. Only Mahaprabhu's intimate associates. And many people, they could hear the shouting, roaring. The whole night there's what's going on in that house.
Соседи, все жители деревни слышали громкие крики, исходящие из этого дома, харибонды, какие-то там странные повизгивания, всякие шумы, и никто не понимал, что там происходит, что они там делают.
I think they must have invited some women and they're all taking intoxication and doing tantra.
Пошли слухи, что там они приглашают каких-то женщин, видимо, на вечеринку, пьют там и тантрой какой-то занимаются.
Oh, the Muslim soldiers, the king, the local king, Chand Qazi, will become angry and he may destroy a whole village just because of this Sivas Thakur. And people were complaining. But actually, inside their heart, they were thinking, I want to see what's going on. So one day, Srivas Thakur's mother-in-law, before the evening time came, she hid in one small room by the side and covered herself with some laundry. And she was waiting for the evening to come. In the evening, Mahaprabhu came and all devotees began Harinam Sankirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Why am I not feeling the usual ecstasy? The ecstasy will not come if someone is present who has a vijati above, another mood. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Srivas Thakur, is there any outsider in your house? Go and check. So Srivas Thakur was going around his house, looking here and there. And then he found some laundry. Aha! What are you doing here? And Srivas Thakur grabbed his mother-in-law by the scruff of the neck and marched out of the house and threw her out. Then he came back, he said, oh Mahaprabhu, now the problem has been solved. You can please continue your kirtan. After some time, there was one young brahmachari. And he came to Srivas Thakur. He said, oh Srivas, please, please, let me see the kirtan of Nimai Pandit. Srivas Thakur said, he said, please. My whole life I was Naishtika Brahmachari. And I even never eat anything except for fruit and milk. I am very austere. And Srivas Thakur's heart melted. He said, all right, I'll hide you in a corner somewhere. So then, before Mahaprabhu and the other associates came, then he hid that brahmachari just behind one door. Okay, just stay there, be quiet, and just you look through the gap, and you can see. Okay, he's coming now. So then that Brahmachari was hiding. And Mahaprabhu came with Advaita Acharya, Gadara Pandit, Nityananda Prabhu, Haridas Thakur, Murari Gupta, all the associates. And they began
Mahasankirtan.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Why am I not feeling the usual ecstasy today? Shivan Thakur? Is there any outsider in your house? No, my lord. Then why am I not feeling the usual ecstasy? Is not exactly an outsider. But there's one brahmachari. Nice brahmachari whole life. And he's very austere. He only eats fruit and milk. Mahaprabhu said, fruit and milk? Does he think he can attain my confidential pastimes by the power of fruit and milk? This is completely bogus. So then that brahmachari, when he heard, he began to criticize himself. Oh, what was I thinking? Fruits and milk. By doing the material austerities, at most in sattva gun, how can you realize that which is nirgun? Beyond the all material energy. And Mahaprabhu's lila is beyond also. So he became very broken hearted. And he was criticizing himself. So Shiva Thakur didn't get him or anything. He himself just came out from the cupboard. Fruits and milk. What was I thinking? Fruits and milk. I'm not qualified. I don't deserve to be here. I'm going. Then when Mahaprabhu saw that he was very humble and he was leaving, he said, Shiva Thakur, go and bring that brahmachari here. Mahaprabhu himself invited him into the kirtan. So he attained the pastimes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. How? By being very humble. And by the mercy of a Vaishnava, Shiva Thakur. So if we can be very humble and have a loving relation with a pure devotee, then we can also enter into the pastimes of Chaitanya. One time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, O Srivas, you are very poor. You don't have a good clothes for yourself or your family members. But all day you are having Harikatha and Kirtan. And you became very skinny, you don't have so much food. So why don't you just get a job?
Может тебе на
работу? Part-time job.
Ну, хоть бы, написано пару часов в день работай, чтобы зарабатывать получше.
Shivas Thakur just smiled.
Shivas Thakur улыбнулся.
He just clapped his hands three times.
Ответ он просто молча хлопнул в ладоши три раза.
Mabu said, what does mean?
Что это значит, вот эти твои планки?
Shivas Thakur said, means I will hear and chant about Krishna all day, and if Krishna doesn't send me any food, I'll fast for one day. Means I'll engage in bhakti to Krishna all day and all night for 2 days, and if Krishna does not send any food, I'll fast for 2 days. And means that if after 3 days Krishna doesn't send what I need, then myself, along with my whole family, will go and jump in the Ganga and drown herself. Because it means that Krishna does not want us to serve him in this body anymore, so we should transfer to another body where he wants us to serve him.
Затем он хлопнул ладоши три раза и сказал, если через 3 дня Кришна не даст нам никакой еды и поддержки, то я отрублю всех своих домочадцев, всю семью, отправимся к берегу реки и утопимся там. Потому что явно это означает, что Кришна не хочет, чтобы мы служили ему в этих телах, хочет переместить нас в новые тела.
So Shivas Thakur is the embodiment of Nishtha in Bhajan, firm faith in Bhajan, and firm faith Krishna will maintain me. Ananyas chintayantu mam ye jana paripasate tesham nitya abhiyuktanam yogakshema vahamyaham. Krishna said, if anyone is always thinking about me at every moment, then how will he live, maintain his life? Don't worry, I will personally protect what he has and whatever he needs, I'll bring it myself. This is absolutely a fact. I have experience in my life. In my life, I never did even one day work. Whole life only
Haribol.
And I'm not starving. So I have very strong faith in Sri Krishna. Follow Shrivas Thakur's example. Oh. One night, Sankirtan was going on. And Shivas Thakur heard just in the next room some crying.
Shivas Thakur услышал где-то в доме какой-то плач, то есть дома исходит плач.
So Shivas Thakur came in to see what was going on.
Он забежал туда в внутренние комнаты посмотреть, что происходит, почему так плачет.
He has 2 wives, they were crying.
И вот было 2 жены, и обе плакали.
And the servants of the house were crying.
Все слуги в доме плакали.
He asked, what happened?
Он спросил, что случилось?
So they told him, oh Shrivas, your son has died.
Они доложили ему, твой сын умер, Shrivas.
He said, is that all?
Он спросил, и все?
You're disturbing the kirtan of Mahaprabhu just for this.
Вы осмелились мешать кирдану Махапрабху из-за смерти моего сына?
Stop crying right now. You've lost a son? If you don't stop crying, you'll lose a husband also. Now be quiet and don't disturb Mahaprabhu's kirtan. Close the door, went back in kirtan. Hari Bol. When the night was almost over, Mahaprabhu had a very beautiful transcendental experience in the kirtan. And at the end of the night, Mahaprabhu said, oh Shrivas, Is there some problem in your house?
He
said, my lord, what problem can there be in my house when your lotus feet are here? Then someone said, oh Mahaprabhu, his son passed away this evening. Then Mahaprabhu got up and went to the room where the body of the child was lying. And he said, hey, come back. And everyone saw the soul of that boy came back and entered back into the body, and he opened his eyes and
said,
and the boy began to speak. He said, I am very fortunate in this life. That by the mercy of Shivas Thakur, oh Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nimai Pandit, I had your darshan. But now my prarabdha karma, that means my allotted time in this body, has come to an end. No one can control where they are born, and when they will die, and where they will go to next. All these things are in the hands of Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. So now, my allotted time in this body has come to the end. So, in accordance with your will, now I am going to my next life. But I pray that I may always remember your lotus feet. Then Mahaprabhu blessed him, and then that soul left again. Then all the ladies and the servants of the house who had been crying and crying, when they saw this, their eyes were opened.
И все присутствующие, все обители, все служанки, все, кто плакал всю ночь напролет по усопшему мальчику, они прозрели и совершенно по-другому восприняли происходящее.
And they realized our life and death. And life and death again and again. It is natural.
Они поняли, что вот это чередование. Рождение, смерть, что это естественный цикл.
Unavoidable.
Это неизбежно.
And we are all in the at the mercy of the Supreme Lord.
И мы ничего с этим сделать не можем, мы полностью в этом зависим от милости Господа. Все это в руках.
And their lamentation was completely removed.
И вся их вот эта горесть прошла.
This pastime is called Shokaharana Lila, the pastime that removes all lamentation from your life.
Вот эта лила называется Шокахарана Лила, которая убирает все невзгоды, все ваши тревоги и печали из жизни.
Yeah, you are immortal.
Что вы должны понять, что вы бессмертны.
You will live forever. You will never die.
Вы будете вечно жить.
Death is nothing. Only changing body. And Supreme Lord is our best friend. Every arrangement He makes is for our benefit. So, never be upset, never be afraid of anything, even death.
Все, что происходит, происходит по воле Господа и ради нашего блага. Поэтому не страшитесь вообще ничего происходящего,
and,
даже смерти.
And those who use their life in the service of Supreme Lord, surely they'll have a most auspicious transcendental destination.
И, конечно же, особенным образом позаботиться о тех, кто служит ему всю жизнь напролет.
Then, afterwards, Mahaprabhu, tears came in his eyes. He said, how could I ever leave a devotee like Shivas Thakur, who does not even care for the passing of his own son, because he's just absorbed in serving me.
Он сказал, как я смогу оставить такого удивительного преданного, как Шривас Такур, который пренебрег смертью собственного сына ради того, чтобы услужить мне?
No one could understand what Mahaprabhu was saying. How could I give up a devotee like Shivas? But the meaning is, in his heart he had decided, I will take sannyas and leave Navadvip. So when Mahaprabhu left Navadvip, Shivas Thakur stayed here for some time. But then the separation was too much. What can he do? Every night was like a million years. How can he pass the night in that place where Gaur Hari used to perform kirtan all night? So the loving separation was too painful, and he left and went back to his ancestral village of Sri Hatta. Always feeling separation. Ha Goranga, ha Gora. But that is only here in this Prakatlila. You should know that Srivas Thakur is here eternally in Shiva Sangam, in his courtyard, dancing with Mahaprabhu and all his associates. Shiva Thakur ki! Shiva Sangam ki! Panchatattva ki! Shiva!